Senator Cornyn.
Thank you, Mr. Zuckerberg, for being here. I note, up until 2014, the mantra or motto of Facebook was move fast and break things. Is that correct?
I don't know when we changed it, but the mantra is currently move fast with stable infrastructure, which is a much less sexy mantra.
Sounds much more boring, but my question is, during the time that it was Facebook's mantra or motto to move fast and break things, do you think some of the misjudgments, perhaps mistakes that you've admitted to here were as a result of that culture or that attitude, particularly as regards to personal privacy of the information of your subscribers?
Senator, I do think that we made mistakes because of that, but the broadest mistakes that we made here are not taking a broad enough view of our responsibility. And wasn't a matter, the move fast cultural value is more tactical around whether engineers can ship things and different ways that we operate. But I think the big mistake that we've made looking back on this is viewing our responsibility as just building tools rather than viewing our whole responsibility as making sure that those tools are used for good.
Well, I appreciate that because previously or early in the past, we've been told that platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and the like are neutral platforms, and the people who own and run those for profit, and I'm not criticizing doing something for profit in this country, but they bore no responsibility for the content. You agree now that Facebook and other social media platforms are not neutral platforms, but bear some responsibility for the content?
I agree that we're responsible for the content. And I think that there's one of the big societal questions that I think we're going to need to answer is the current framework that we have is based on this reactive model that assumed that there weren't AI tools that could proactively tell whether something was terrorist content or something bad. So it naturally relied on requiring people to flag for a company and then the company needing to take reasonable action. In the future, we're going to have tools that are going to be able to identify more types of bad content. And I think that there are moral and legal obligation questions that I think we'll have to wrestle with as a society about when we want to require companies to take action proactively on certain of those things that gets in the way of...
I appreciate that. I have 2 minutes left to ask you questions. So you interestingly, the terms of the terms of service is a legal document which discloses to your subscribers how their information is going to be used, how Facebook is going to operate. And but you concede that you doubt everybody reads or understands that legalese, those terms of service. So is that to suggest that the consent that people give subject to that terms of service is not informed consent? In other words, they may not read it, and even if they read it, they may not understand it?
I just think we have a broader responsibility than what the law requires. So
I appreciate that. What I'm asking about in terms of what your subscribers understand in terms of how their data is going to be used. But let me go to the terms of service. Under paragraph number 2, you say you own all of the content and information you post on Facebook. That's what you've told us here today a number of times. So if I choose to terminate my Facebook account, can I bar Facebook or any third parties from using the data that I had previously supplied for any purpose whatsoever?
Yes, Senator. If you delete your account, we should get rid of all of your information.
You should, or
we do.
Do you?
We do.
How about third parties that you have contracted with to use some of that underlying information, perhaps to target advertising for themselves? You can't. Do you claw back that information as well, or does that remain in their custody?
Well, Senator, this is actually a very important question. I'm glad you brought this up because there's a very common misperception about Facebook that we sell data to advertisers. And we do not sell data to advertisers. Well, we don't sell data
to anyone. Clearly rent it.
What we allow is for advertisers to tell us who they want to reach, and then we do the placement. So if an advertiser comes to us and says, all right, I'm a ski shop and I want to sell skis to women, then we might have some sense because people shared skiing-related content or said they were interested in that. They shared whether they're a woman. And then we can show the ads to the right people without that data ever changing hands and going to the advertiser. That's a very fundamental part of how our model works and something that is often misunderstood. So I appreciate that you brought that up.
Thank you, Senator Cornyn. We had indicated earlier on that